Let's talk about adding secret management to our architecture. What we have here now is a way to manage our secrets. And instead of keeping them inside of the Kubernetes cluster, or let's say in a pipeline for the deployment, we'll actually be using a managed key store. In our case, we're going to be using Azure Key Vault. There are advantages of using Azure Key Vault. Other options here would be, let's say, HashiCorp's Key Vault. That would work as well. With Azure Key Vault, the advantage is that you not only have a way to provide access, specific access to Key Vault and to this keys and secrets and certificates there, but we also have an audit log that is part of Key Vault. That coupled with access from Azure Active Directory makes for a really strong option here. The way we're going to work out this is we need to use pod manage identities to allow a certain pod, in our case, traffic, to access secrets from the specific store in Key Vault. So in our diagram here, noticing that this will be a node and this is a pod. So this is our traffic pod. That pod, once it bootstraps and it needs to have access to the certificates, will then use manage identities and the RBAC specified for that manage identity to retrieve the secrets from Key Vault. And once that those secrets flow back into the pod, what's going to happen is, from a pod perspective, really you have the secrets just mounted in the file system. So let's say under like slash secrets. So you'd have those files accessible for the pod for the duration of the lifetime of that pod. So once the pod is terminated, that's all gone. Again, this is an interesting concept. And to achieve that, we're going to be coupling Azure Key Vault, so Key Vault on this side here, with the secret store CSI driver. That operation, it's made very straightforward with the CSI driver. CSI driver can do much more than what we are doing for this example here, but this will achieve what we want. So we're not only going to retrieve the public keys that are stored here on Key Vault, so all the certs are in here, but also the private one, so that traffic can do the TLS termination in here. For security updates, you want to make sure that you stay within a certain number of supported versions. For us, N-2 versions. You want to be able to upgrade to the latest version as much as you can due to a lot of things, such as change in the API or enhancements in Kubernetes. We get those from upstream and then we package them. So make sure that you are within the N-2 versioning. Now, the other thing that you want to keep in mind is that there are ways that you can update the node image. We do provide weekly node image updates, and there are also some daily updates. Take a look at the documentation that follows on this video here, and see what works well for you in your scenario. One last thing and an interesting consideration here is that you can use Azure Security Center, ASC, to monitor the node for suspicious activity. So in case something happens to your node, ASC is there to help you out. You can leverage that tool to get more visibility and insight in a node.